Hello guys, welcome to the demo gameplay of Mr. Prepper. I have been waiting for this game since last year and I'm very excited to try it now. Recently, the demo was released on Steam as a part of their Steam Gameplay Festival. So all of you can check it out as the link is given in the description. Now coming on the game, the one thing which I feel is very special is it focuses on preparing for an upcoming nuclear disaster rather than focusing on same old post-nuclear scenarios. They are providing something which is less explored till now. The game looks very interesting and has few elements of other games like This War of Mine or Sims. Now coming towards the music of this game, the music feels very calm and it's quite good actually. So let's start building our bunker to get prepared for the nuclear situation, which is clearly shown in the main screen, and see how it feels.
Ever since the plague and the change of the government, this town has been unbearable, lifeless, filled only with boredom, propaganda, and control. I've tried to escape, and I've failed this time. But I'll find a way. They call me Mr. Prepper.
So basically, Mr. Prepper has attempted to flee from the town as he is annoyed by the situation of his town and its government. But after the failed attempt, the agency has taken his vehicle and they are keeping a close eye on Mr. Prepper. Let's complete the basic tutorial first. There is a small tip here guys. You can also change the settings so that Mr. Prepper always runs instead of walking slowly. Now to keep Mr. Prepper fully prepared, we need to keep track of these three basic needs: hunger, rest, and preparedness. As you can see, the ultimate plan is kind of empty right now, but as per the developers, this will get filled with more details in the final game. So after reading our so-called ultimate plan, the first main objective is to build the first room in the bunker. So Mr. Prepper will start digging right away, and as you can see, we are receiving pieces of the ground as we dig the room, and this can be converted into room soil later on. Now these goals are further divided into subsequent goals, like upgrading the workbench so that we can build a ladder and go down the bunker. Now we need 5 metal pieces and 15 wood pieces to upgrade our workbench. Plus we also need 3 metal pieces to create a ladder. So metal is to be purchased by our trading, and the trading can only be done by clicking on the post box outside our main door. Now coming to the wood, it can be collected in form of logs from the forest. To reach the forest, all we have to do is take the help of the road sign. Now, after collecting the logs, these logs can be dismantled at our current workbench to obtain wood from them. A little tip here, you can also find some berries like blueberries when you visit the forest. Just don't forget to either eat them or store them in the refrigerator to preserve them for few days. Now the next thing to do is creating lamps from the glass. Glass can be easily obtained by dismantling a couple of cups or plates from the kitchen. Hmm. this is how our first day comes to an end. Till now, we were doing pretty much what we were told to do, and there was hardly any room for anything else. The second day starts with the clock on the top and the agent at our doorstep. Things are surely getting exciting. Now, we have to cover our tracks to keep our plan a secret. Three things that can look suspicious to the agent are the plan, the workbench, and the bunker hatch. The most important one is the bunker hatch. So to cover our track, first thing to do is to turn the plan around, then grab the workbench and finally cover the hatch with a cloth. And by doing these things, we will achieve a 5-point rating from the agency without raising any alarm. Now finally we can enjoy some freedom and work things at our own pace and look into other stuff as well. The first thing to do is conveniently putting all suspicious stuff under one place, that is our bunker. Now the next main objective is to grow our own food. This one is simple. All we need is some floor soil from our workbench, some seeds which are already stored in our kitchen, and some water from the sink. But for all of this, we need to build another bigger room or maybe three smaller rooms and a ladder to descend further in the bunker. So let's be on top of it, guys. Now there is a trick to place our plan. In order to place the plan in the bunker, we have to put it on the highest point of the wall, otherwise it is unreadable at times. As you can see, there are some bonuses which are triggered in certain situations like happy agent and higher preparedness, etc. And these somehow helps Mr. Prepper in various ways. So at the end of day 2, we have our second underground floor ready to use. We have 8 seeds, 3 metals, 8 room soils and 5 water from the sink. Let's start our day 3. Working towards our next goal, I have everything ready except few lamps which we have to create from the glass collected from the kitchen. We need a couple of lamps to provide heat for our garden. I'll create 5 of those to get the best result. As soon as all 5 of these soil patches are laid down, seeded and watered, we can check our plan for the next objective. This takes us to the official end of this demo, but like me, if you are wondering what else is there to do, we will explore a little bit more. As we can see, almost everything can be dismantled to get all kind of material like metal, wood, glass, fabric, plastic, even electronic parts. But as we know, the agency will regularly check for all the essential items, and we still don't know what is essential and what can be dismantled without alarming the agent. Next thing we have is some food options like various jams that require fruits, sugar and glass. But as of right now, I'm not sure how to get sugar. Then moving on, some dishes that require hunting or gathering and preparing traps basically. Further down the menu comes the soups, which simply requires vegetables and water. These can be helpful in the early game because the first thing we set up in our bunker is a guard. Also, one more thing I noticed is that the soups give you more health than roasted chicken. So focus on those homegrown veggies. We can collect chicken from the forest after setting up a trap. Talking about setting traps, there are few things to understand to successfully catch your first chicken. Firstly, traps are consumed in process, so you will get back only the chicken. And secondly, you need a bait to catch the animal. Now, I am assuming different baits will be used to lure different animals, but as of now, I can only catch a chicken. Now looking at the workbench, we can create all sort of items like beds, chairs, tables, books, traps, plates, glasses, etc. But the workbench itself cannot be upgraded further in this demo. Finally, we have almost checked everything in this demo, and to conclude, I would say that this is a very promising game, one I would surely recommend all of you to play. The demo shows lots of things to do and looks very promising regarding the in-hand experience. So if you like it, just add it to your Steam wishlist and wait till the next one for the planned release. Also, check out all the links given in the description.